Hey everybody, what is going on? I know it has been a minute since I've been on my channel, but life has been so amazing and crazy lately. I'm a mess. I just got off work. The house is a mess. Everything's a mess, but it's all worth it. We are finally moving! So, today I am going to do an 18% TCA peel, and I'm so excited about it. I have done these peels in the past up to 12%. I had like so much coffee today because I know I'm gonna be packing. Got it from makeupartistchoice.com. It's a website. They're not sponsoring this video or anything. I just absolutely love that website. I get everything on there. If anyone has had problems with their acne and you've tried everything like myself, like I have tried it all, you guys. I've tried Clearasil, Neutrogena, Proactive, charcoal masks, PMD. I've done a lot of stuff. I've never gone to an esthetician because they've been like way too expensive. I just never really trusted that. I know that's kind of weird. I remember a long time ago when I first had my cystic acne, what originally just wiped it out was one of the peels that I did, and I believe it was a 12%. My mom actually did it for me. The reason why it took so well was because it was the first time that I did it. But since then, I have a lot of scarring, a lot of discoloration, a lot of uneven toning, and this peel is going to take care of all of that. If I can get my life together, there we go. So if you guys are interested in to see how this peel turns out, then please keep watching. Tell me if you guys can see my skin. Maybe it'll be better for you guys to see it more in the natural light. You know what's so funny? For the longest time, I was like so uncomfortable and nervous for vlogging outside. But then I'm like, what if there's people that are going through like the same things or have like the same questions or whatever? Like, you can't just hide in the dark forever. And I don't hide in my house because I have acne. So, hello. I'm trying to help some people out here. Yeah, I have a lot of like discoloration. Don't mind the hairiness. Yeah. But we'll be pretty again. So let's head to the stove. Between a triple antibiotic.
So there's three ingredients in there. If you look on the back, that are first eight antibiotics. So you have bacitracin, neomycin, and poly.
So if it, I mean, it just calls for antibiotic. Would this be? It's an. I don't know if you know. It's all right. It's an 18% chemical peel.
I don't know anything about it.
Oh, do they all say triple?
So these are all triple because these are all Neosporin brand. And then you have like, if you're looking for singles, like polymycin.
And this says multi, so this might be good too if it just says multi antibiotic with pain relief.
Yep, so basically it's a triple antibiotic with a pain.
I think I'm gonna do this one then. Okay. Yeah, and then I'll get the anti itch cream as well. Okay, thanks so much. Appreciate your help. Alrighty, so we're gonna do this, is what he recommended, and then the anti itch cream. I am so happy we're moving, y'all. I live in the wretched side of town. I don't know what it is, but every time I get on my channel and I have the camera, I'm like, I just want to throw some words of inspiration to you guys. I'm so happy for all the good things that have been coming our way recently. Like my boyfriend and I have gone through a lot. He's gone through a lot by himself. I've gone through a lot on my own. So it's good to kind of have a break. When I say we're blessed, and for me or for anyone in general, I don't think blessings is necessarily receiving really nice things, house, cars, shoes, clothes, all that stuff, because I think that all that stuff I believe that you have to work for. A blessing to me is being able to wake up and be healthy and have a healthy body, like be able to walk and use your 10 fingers and 10 toes. And some people can't use those. Some people wake up and they don't have those. Some people don't even wake up. And we're blessed to have the opportunity to go out and work and grind so that we can try to get the things that we need and want. My mother has always stressed to me, you don't ever want to be surviving, working just to pay all your bills, just to put enough food in the house, to have nothing in your account. That's surviving, you know what I mean? She says you always want to live. We've worked so hard, we've been so healthy, and we've been, you know, God has put us in such a healthy state for our bodies and our mind and our mental state, and it wasn't easy all the time, but we were able to do what we needed to be able to accomplish what we can, so we don't have to feel like we're surviving every day constantly anymore. We're gonna start living, and it took a really long time, and there's still a lot more that we want to do, and me myself, that I want to share with you guys and that we have coming up. I think hard work will get you to where you want to be, but you just have to be so thankful for the fact that you are blessed to wake up and still be able to function. I always try to think about people that have it worse and still do more. So don't ever take the fact that you have a job for granted. It might be a shitty job, but you know, that shitty job is the one that's paying your bills. Your education, man, so many people don't have the opportunity to get an education. If you can do it, man, do it. Go to school, get your education, y'all. So, on a lighter note, I get my anti-age cream. We finna go do this peel. Let's go. So we stopped at good old Walgreens. Petroleum gelato. To protect my eyes, nose, corners of your mouth, and lips. Very important, so they don't peel or burn. Anti-itch cream, and then you can use it for other things if you need it, but that isn't that my business. A multiple antibiotic with pain relief. First aid antibiotic pain relieving cream. Ooh, so yeah, we're gonna use this too. Total for all these items in my area at Walgreens came to $11.69. The petroleum jelly was $1. The antibiotic cream was $5.29 and the anti-itch cream was $4.79. Prior to the peel, one of the things that you have to do is wash your face with a gentle, or their recommended green tea pomegranate moisturizer, or girl, cleanser, okay? Let me get this eye real quick. I'm going to take a shower and wash my face with this gently with my fingertip, and we will start the peel. For this one, I'm going to be using Q-tips for my face. One thing that I remembered that my mom used the first time she did my peel was she actually used a fan brush. It was never used. She only used it specifically for that peel, and she would just kind of apply it with the fan brush. I never had any issues with it. The brush was okay. None of the pieces of the brush ever got in my skin. I never got an infection, but the directions recommend a Q-tip or a cotton pad, so I guess that's what I'll do. So yeah, I'm done talking. Jump in the shower, and I'll see you guys when I'm done. Guys, so when you get this kit, what we have here is we have a green tea pomegranate cleanser that they recommend to use because it's very sensitive. The 18% TCA peel, it's about 5 ounces. This will last you, it says 10 peels. And then the neutralizer that you're gonna put on your face when you're ready to rinse your peel. Now, if you get the sample size of the peel, you don't get this neutralizer, but you can create it yourself. And the neutralizer is a combination of water and baking soda. And then you would just apply that to your face after you are finished with the 18% TCA peel and you are ready to remove it. Then they also give you some gloves, which is really nice too. And Makeup Artist Choice always sends you a little sample of something. What'd they send us this time? A blemish buster cleanser. So cool. You get started onto this. Alright you guys, so I just took a shower. My face is completely dry after using the pomegranate cleanser, green tea pomegranate cleanser, and I just made sure I used my fingertips. I was very, very gentle with it. So the next thing I'm going to do is take my petroleum jelly. I'm gonna wash my hands really quickly, and then we're gonna start the peel. You can apply this peel to your face.
It's 12 o'clock.
Thank you. And then leave it on for 5 minutes. If you've done this peel previously, I'm literally reading from the pamphlet, and you feel like you need more strength, apply the first layer. You can wait 5 minutes and then apply a second layer and leave it on for between 3 to 5 minutes. This is gonna give you a 25% boost. And when you remove it, you don't want to use a textured cloth because it's going to irritate your skin. What I like to use for my skin personally, if you go to the Dollar Tree, they have like these microfiber cloths that are just really soft. And you actually, a lot of people use them to clean their car, but I like to use that whenever I do a peel. Then you're going to dab, you don't want to pull. You want to make sure that you guys have an accurate timer. So after we apply the peel, we're going to go in with our neutralizer and then apply it to our face with a clean washcloth, and then once that's on, I'm gonna go back in with that green tea moisturizer that I have, and then I'm going to wash my face with this. So now we are going to put our gloves on and start. And we're gonna start at the forehead first. Mm-hmm. Is this where you went? Is this where you left me? Is this where you leave me? Then I'm gonna go in and apply a second layer just because I want the 25% boost because I think my scars and acne are very severe. So whenever you see, here, let's zoom in for you guys. Okay, whenever you see this kind of stuff, how the skin is turning white, this is called frosting and it is completely normal, and you can almost see that it's happening right here on my cheek as well. Not so much on my forehead, but you can see it's getting a little white in here. Can you guys tell that? And, you can see the skin is like, it's getting very tight and very dry. So that's totally normal. If it's hot, I mean, definitely like feel free to like grab the brochure and fan your face. I mean, but I can definitely stand it. It's not anything crazy for me. Officially 5 minutes. Thank you, ma'am. We're gonna go back in with our second layer. This is where you run. This ain't what you used to. This is like that rose in a thorn bush. I don't have a washcloth, but I have a very clean towel, which is like an area. I'm just gonna pull it up like this and get my neutralizer. Now we're applying the neutralizer, thank you ma'am, to the towel and putting it on our freshly, thank you, processed skin. And when you do this, you're gonna basically see like how the frosting is going away because it is completely just like stopping that. And some more. And when I wash my face, I'm gonna be careful. We'll be done a little bit so you can see the chin. Men don't have to do any of this. Or, you know what, I take that back. I don't know. Are there any men that you guys think have actually done this? Because I would like to know that us women are not alone. But honestly, though, like, this is a personal choice. Like, acne has been, like, a part of my life for a couple years now. It just became, like, so embarrassing to the point, like, where I didn't ever, like, I didn't want to leave the house. I didn't want to go out and do things. Like, I feel like it really interfered with, like, my social life, you know? I was just, like, so embarrassed. So now I feel like I got everything except for here. I'm gonna go in the bathroom with this green tea moisturizer. Gently wash my face with my fingertips, and then I'll come back, pat it dry very, very lightly, and show you guys what it looks like. So my face is wet right now. I just washed it with the green tea moisturizer. I know my skin is still white, but it is not frosting, okay? It doesn't burn anymore. So now I'm using a new section of the towel, and I'm just so gently. This is the part that I think people forget about and overlook all the time, is that they're not gentle enough on their skin. All right, you guys, so this is currently what I'm looking like. These areas are white because I did go back and do the sides of my nose and underneath, because I realized that I only did like the chin area, but I didn't get like those whiteheads that were underneath my lips. So I went and did that. Yeah, it's definitely red, and it is swelling in certain areas, you can see. So tomorrow, it's pretty much going to look the same. I'm going to wake up, use the green tea pomegranate cleanser, just clean, soft towel, apply the antibiotic, and then by the fourth day, it'll start peeling. Like I said, it takes a total of 10 days for this to work, but drinking a lot of water does help the process. Yeah, this is pretty much how I'm looking right now. Day one, the peel, and I'm gonna touch base with you guys, I guess throughout the process. So, because I'm not really gonna have anything else I can do as far as makeup looks. So yeah, I will see you guys on day two, just to kind of touch base with you. And yeah, thanks for watching. I'm seeing pink 'cause I've been looking at